same movies, the same song every time, guys. Still can't figure it out. Welcome to the shit show, everybody. How you doing tonight? Yeah, I like to hear a good warm audience. Very cool. We got some late arrivers. It's Allie, Rachel, and Tony, guys, on the false roof. Cool. So who has never been to a shit show or an improv show before? Wow, okay. Y'all, oh man, y'all are in for a ride, let me tell you. Tonight, you've never been to an improv show, you don't know what to expect. Neither do we. Half of the show tonight is not planned at all. Like, we're gonna come out here and make it up and hope it works. The other half of the show tonight is a sketch, like SNL style, and we're gonna have lines that we're also gonna make up because we didn't win the scripts. So it's 100% improv. We're gonna call it half a sketch. Sound good?
Yep.
Yeah. See if you guys can figure out which one's which. A little game. Don't look at the play bills. Do your best guess, and you might win a prize. No prizes from us. However, there are prizes tonight from Catching Through Music in that raffle. Who got in the raffle? Anybody? All right, that's a good amount of you. So you can buy into the raffle up until the end of intermission. So if you're like, oh, those prizes look nice, go ahead and get in on that. It'll be a good time. Other thing happening tonight, it is Blake Stockton's last show. For most of you, that doesn't matter. You've never been to a show before. but who has been to a show? Can I hear you? Guys, can I just hear a good old round of cheering for Blake real fast? Just come on. We've done 21 shows. I think Blake did 19 of them. He had to miss two for some reason. He's a little bitch. but it's been a pleasure having him. He writes a lot of the sketch for the team. He can't act really, but he's a real Rudy of the team. Hey, forever, you know? but it's a pleasure having him. So we got the raffle, we got Blake. But the most important thing tonight, ladies and gentlemen, I broke a promise this month to an audience member named Tom. Now, last month, Tom came to this show. He had on a pink shirt, similar to this one. But instead of birds, there were sharks. And I told Tom, buddy, you come back next month, I will get that shirt and wear it. I'm like, where I get it? And he goes, Old Navy. He lied. Fucking lied. I went to the Old Navy at the town center. I went to Old Navy at the mall. No shark shirt! However, there was a pink shirt with birds, so I wore this. And guess what? I'm not the only one who broke a promise. Tom, would you stand up real fast? Tom is wearing a blue shirt, which is not pink, and has what? Cauliflower?
Yeah. Large fishies.
Large fishies.
Yeah.
Are large fishies sharks, ladies and gentlemen? The answer is no. Anyways, we can boo Tom shortly. Show, we're not going to do that. Just some Run DMC. This isn't funny. He's fucking up the flow of the show at this point. I really need you all to appreciate it.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
I'm doing the open. I'm doing the intro. I'm doing the open and the intro. You got, what are you wearing?
This is my time to shine as the woman of Underdog.
Look at Little House on the Prairie, went to the mall for once.
Speaking of malls, Tom, your wife should do a better job. Please leave the stage.
Fine. You know what? Whatever. I'm going to listen to some hip hop and get in the right mood.
Ladies, gentlemen, I've been looking forward to this day for one solid month. The day in which I could shine as the woman of Underdog. As the female force that comes out and says, we want to do good. We want to be right. We want to rise above those that would hold us down into debauchery. So we're going to add a little bit of class tonight. If you have noticed, we have teamed with a lovely organization called Connecting Through Music. And at this time, I would like to have Mr. Muth come up to the stage.
Mike.
Yeah. You're on a first name basis, it's fine.
Good. I'm so impressed.
Yes. Yeah. Here's so,
you. Hi, how are you?
Hi.
So, thank you. Thank you. First of all, I just want to let you know that Blake, he has helped Connected Through Music for the last 3 years through the UNF Small Business Program. He helped us create our website, and he taught me everything that I know about technology. And yes, just about. I was working off my iPhone for about 5 years when I decided to start this organization, so he's really helped me come a long way. But just to tell you a quick story, my husband and I, Carsten, we have 3 children, and at 47, I became pregnant. We were living in Florence, Italy, and Dante was born. And Dante was born with autism, Down syndrome, and without an esophagus. So that started a journey. We came back to the States. He ended up going to Boston Children's Hospital for a year in the ICU, 26 surgeries, 200 days on a ventilator, kind of changed our whole path in life. But what we learned was that he's happy. He is one of the happiest, most joyful children. But what brought his ability to communicate with others was music. I brought music into the home, and all of a sudden he was playing with instruments instead of battery-operated toys, dancing around and sharing them with people. So I went to Neptune Beach Elementary School and I started Connecting Through Music. And there's 7 classrooms, there's 93 children there, and they're receiving 1.5 hours of music enrichment and kinder music. Bach to Rock is there, and we have board certified music therapists. We're also at Mandarin Oaks Elementary School, and this summer we donated 100 hours to 4 programs in the city that have children with special needs. Music therapy, there's so much research behind it that demonstrates that children with special needs, they learn through music. It touches a different part of our brain, and we are here to bring it to this community. The interesting thing is there's probably only 10 to 12 music therapists in this county. So one, we want to spread the word that music therapy is a gold standard for children with special needs to learn. Two, we want to get music therapists to relocate down here. And then, because down in South Florida, Central Florida, and up in the Northeast, there's a ton of music therapists. And then the other is we need to raise funding, because we're a 501c3, but it's all community-based. So nights like this help us to provide this music therapy. All of the board members, it's all pay it forward, we're all volunteer-based. And so tonight, whatever you pay for in a raffle, we're going to provide music therapy. We have a budget that's $180,000 a year, and we still have to raise $100,000 this year, but we'll do it because it's the right thing to do for these kids. So I want to thank you for being here, and now we're going to give something back to you.
Yes.
Via the raffle prize, right?
Just as a heads up, we're only going to give away 6 items now, and then we will proceed to give 6 items away after intermission. So you do have the opportunity to get raffle tickets at intermission if you did not do so before the show. Karen, may I pull the first number for the first prize?
This is Nancy. This is Nancy, our COO.
Wonderful. Actually, Karen, would you like to pull the first number for a Brunch House gift card?
Do y'all trust me?
At $25.
Okay, let's see. Who wants a wonderful brunch?
I love Brunch House.
We have Tina W.
Tina W. Oh, look at this, the service here.
Yeah, with a smile.
All right, and then the next one is going to be?
For the Loop, it's a $50 gift certificate for the Loop.
I'm gonna go with, I'm gonna try it upside down. I tried it, it's not. Lana C or Lana? Lana?
The really neat thing is Lena has a child at Neptune Beach Elementary School who's going to enjoy this music, so that's awesome.
Oh, that's fantastic.
Yes. I just met her tonight, so that's awesome.
Oh man, $50 Loop gift card. We should be friends.
Yeah.
Hey, Grassfield. You think you're the only one who can dress up like a queen?
You have a collar sticking hanging out of your dress.
Oh, am I not pretty enough for you?
What is this trash?
What are you talking about? This is my finest good role fun.
I see the way it matches your toe focus.
Yeah, it's not easy living on the streets like this. Up on the next one. What do you got?
What's up next?
Bluetooth earphones donated by AT&T on Atlantic Boulevard.
Gift bag from the PGA.
That's what Matt, you just won! A $200 gift bag?
I hear we're giving away.
What the heck?
No!
Did you bust a. What is this? Did you bust a strap?
My ladies wanted to come out. No, no. No, no.
Okay, so you want to drop, what is this one for?
Now, this is how you're going to get your message out in life. So it's 5-yard signs, double-sided, a 4x6 full-color banner, and $50 off any other promotional item from Promo 180.
But this could be for anything.
Yes,
I'm
anything.
I'm looking to promote my strapless bra.
You can say, I am a goddess with a strapless bra. It's a $250 value.
I hope this is me. I've got some things I want to advertise.
Nancy, T? Can we put that in?
Turn around!
Nancy, what are you going to advertise, baby?
What do you think? I guess.
Last one.
Okay.
This is the last one for this.
So we're going to do a Cole Haynes basket.
Apple prices to make a living, this is the look. I mugged a homeless man with it.
Cole Haynes.
Lana Seaman!
Yeah!
Lana, tonight's the night.
Again, you guys will be able to purchase...
You can buy her at the half. Get off my stage, Riz.
Ladies and gentlemen, how you doing right now? How you guys feel right now?
Good.
Are you comfortable?
Yeah.
I'm glad. That's all. Front row, are you okay with this?
Oh yeah.
Scott, turn that down. You know, this is about appreciating bodies in every right. Alright? I may not be the Blake of the group, chiseled with abs or whatever. I might have a six-pack of beer hiding here, okay? Just because it comes in different shapes and sizes doesn't mean it's wrong. I mean, well, we all got a cause, right? What's your cause, man?
Hookers and blow.
Hookers and blow! We all perfect!
You're probably a little cold.
My nipples are hard. Alright, are you guys ready to play? So,
you look like a homeless Bohemian Rhapsody guy.
Is this a real life or just fantasy, you know? Who knows? Our next game is called Moving Bodies. Now, don't worry, I'll be off the stage, so you don't have to see this move a whole lot more. First things first, though, I need two volunteers for this game. So I gotta get two brave souls who are willing to put it all on the line. You can keep your clothes on, don't worry. You don't gotta go this far. All you're gonna have to do is move Blake and Kevin around just a little bit. Just a couple of hands up. A couple of ballsy folks. Anybody? We got one right there. Oh, we got two volunteers! Box is, it's not like fitting, it's not form fitting, you know? It's like slipping a little bit. Anyways, what's your name, man? Come on, what's this?
Nancy.
Nancy, everybody! Nancy. Hey. Say your name.
Al.
Al, come on, buddy. Give it up for Nancy now! How moving bodies works is the following. Blake and Kevin throughout the entire show will be able to move freely and do what they want. However, for this game only, they lose the ability to move. So if you want them to move, Nancy, Al, I'll let you pick who you want to use. You're going to have to move their arms, point them, turn their heads like that. If you want them to walk, you're going to tap their legs or pull on their leg, then they'll move around the stage. Really, they can't move at all. So if they have to move, you have to do it. Who do you want to move? Okay, we'll take Kevin.
Come on, Nancy, let's do it.
Now, here's the thing. Kevin is married, and Blake has one kid, so you be careful. Don't touch their naughty bits. None of this, right? The box zone is off limits, is all I'm trying to say. I should have a top one. There we go. You guys go ahead, put them in whatever starting position you want. Move them however you choose. Go ahead and pose them. From you guys, one last thing. One last thing before I go. Can I give a suggestion of a location that would require a whole lot of movement?
Football game.
A football game. Thank you guys, this is Moving Bodies. And 3, 2, 1.
I pledge allegiance to the flag. Are you not gonna say it with me?
Are you not gonna pick your boogers with me?
Oh, we're doing that?
It's been our pregame ritual for the last 3 seasons, bro. Come on.
I'm gonna pick a booger.
Yes, that's exactly what I wanted you to do.
We always win when I go in the right nostril.
We're number one. When we pick our boogers, for the first game, we always win.
We always win.
Look at that sun. Look at that sunset.
I would love to look at the sunset, but I am so hot right now.
Look at the sunset, right? It's part of the point.
That is a fantastic sunset!
It's beautiful.
I feel like I'm going a little blind though, and it's fair. YMCA. Why?
Own buttocks that you can't even hear what anybody else has to say. I tell you what, you think you are just cooler than the number one wolf himself, that number one D-O-G, that G-O-D. Ow, ow!
Shadrack, you get me so excited when you hail like that.
He is risen!
Speaking of getting excited,
yeah.
Tell us a little bit about Lust.
Bowls down to two things.
Come on.
Titties, dicks. It ain't your tit. It ain't your dick, don't touch it. No, don't look at it, unless you're married to it. And then if you are married to said titty or dick, you can't just touch it anytime you want. It's called consent. I tell you what, do not be a dirty dick digger. Tit teaser. You know what I'm sick of most of all? These little girls running around with their tits all flopping around! Cover them up, ladies. Cover them up. Nobody wants to see that. God gave you clothes, wear them. I've got a long lineage of victim shaming, and I ain't afraid to break it up today on these airways.
Amen. You know, Shadrack.
Yeah!
Speaking of blood, I went to this place recently called South Beach, Miami. I was walking down the beach and I saw these two.
You're just strolling down the beach of South Beach?
Yeah, just walking by myself, okay? Uh-huh. I saw these two men just cuddling on the beach, all oiled up, tan, like very muscular, and they were in thongs, and I was getting all excited, and I'm like, stop it! That's the end of the story.
Do we need to have a commercial break so no. You can pray a little bit there a minute ago?
No, let's keep the show rolling. Tell us a little bit about gluttony.
Gluttony, okay, good segue there, sir. Okay, just check. Still a little risen. Gluttony, I'm sorry. You got me distracted there. Now I'm gonna take myself to the Home Depot. I'm running errands. I'm going around town. I'm just thinking about it. I'm just gonna. You know what? I'm hungry. I'm very hungry. I'm gonna be good to myself. I'm gonna treat my body like the temple that it is. I'm gonna stop for one of them acai bowls. I'm gonna treat myself all nice and clean. Keep it all nice and clean. And out the corner of my eye, what happens? It's that red glow of the devil with that hot and ready sign from the heavenly plane. I tell you what, that's the devil himself. I tell you what, God don't want no fatties in heaven. It's like a fatty over there, and it will weigh down. It will start, the beams will start bowing down if we get too many fatties up there.
Be nice.
No, I'm being nice, but I'm telling you right now that if your IQ is lower than your cholesterol, you ain't getting in them pearly gates.
I guess that makes sense.
Of course it does. It's coming from my mouth.
Right. Let's wrap this show up, all right? Last but not least on the list is Indy.
Ooh.
Yes. Listen, out of all of them, it's the one that gets me the most.
I can tell by the way you said. Why don't you tell us about it then, Abednego?
It would be my pleasure.
Take it.
All right. You see, Indy starts out as this little tiny seed inside of you. Kind of like how a baby is inside. And it starts small, and you don't even realize it until it's grown and growing, and it's kicking a little bit. And then you start looking at your cute friends and boys and girls, a lot of boys and some girls too. and you give them dirty looks because they're so cute, but you gotta remember, they're not ugly, pretty inside, they're ugly and simple.
Mm-hmm.
But Andy keeps growing and growing, and it starts kicking a little bit. Before you know it, Andy is out, clawing its way out of your body, and it's screaming, and you're yelling at your friend Janice. Janice, oh, what a nice, cute dress, Janice. One of a kind, Janice. Must be nice to have a parent, husband to drive you to Paris, France, Janice.
Drive you to Paris, France.
I'm angry. Listen, the moral of the story is, abort your Andy, not your babies.
And blessed be ye!
improv for you. What we're going to do is called an invocation. We're going to summon the spirits of, you know, whatever your suggestion is, because we're summoning things and it's improv.
Great.
Can I get a suggestion of any word at all that's just not food?
Jaguars.
Jaguar. Great. Jaguar.
You are a car.
It is often confused with a leopard. Leopard, not a leopard.
You are a football team.
You are covered in brown spots and have a tail.
You are found at the Jacksonville Zoo.
You are the first sign of a midlife crisis in most men.
Thou art the word which pronunciation we use to tell if you were out of town or from Jacksonville.
Thou art playing a game right now that many beautiful people are forgiving for comedy.
Thou art my favorite animal to watch on the Discovery Channel.
Thou art owned by our great Lord Shadkan.
Thou art a ravenous beast capable of tearing to shreds any animal it chooses,
but also can be quite cute at times.
Thou art maybe competitively as fast as the cheetah.
I am debt.
I am speed.
I have fleas.
I am sportsmanship.
I am Jaguar.
Get out of here,
cold one. Yeah, cold one, buddy?
No, I don't have a cold one because I am the ghost of Blake Bortles. You guys are not getting rid of me. I know it's preseason tonight at the stadium, but I am still here to screw your season up!
We get your ghost, man. You don't really have to do
this. I would have just been scared of the regular Blake Bortles.
You show up, oh god, he's gonna drop my vase or something.
I bet you know who I am.
No.
I'm the ghost of Blaine Gabbert.
Worse than I do.
I'm pretty sure I'm still employed. I don't know.
I want a playoff game.
If these two are here, we're never getting laid again.
Why do you say that?
Because they can't score.
Well, it's just all over, man. It's all over. I can't.
Well, scabies is a real thing.
I didn't believe it. I didn't believe it at first.
I told you not everything is a myth. I don't know why you took
if
that.
If I don't see it or experience it, I don't believe it.
Why did you take that trip to Daytona Beach? It is the armpit of Florida. That place is filthy.
It's just laid in the sand. Do you think I got it from the sand?
It's probably with that woman you laid up with. What was her name?
At Lollipops?
Miss Lollipop. Yes.
Come get cozy with Miss Lollipop. Me, I'm a lollipop.
No.
I know what that means.
I really just came here for like a single boys trip. But after I see this, I'm really second guessing. I mean, I don't even have to do anything. You're just coming
You look beautiful.
She acts like the crab, so I should have expected the crabs.
You know what? I have a home remedy. There was this one time on spring break, early 1999, I fooled around.
Morning, babe.
Hi.
You're gonna notice a little something in a couple of hours. Don't worry, I've got the remedy.
Did you make me breakfast?
Ooh. No, you're not gonna wanna eat this.
All right. I love surprises.
Hey, cutie.
Hi.
Come to the spring break bar often?
Oh, I do.
You know what? What's wrong? Am I not cute enough for you?
You are.
Choke me. Yeah.
My fingernails fell off. It gave me some type of weird fungus from touching it.
Fell off?
Touching her neck.
You're right. Why did you should have told me about this about Daytona before I went.
I did. You never listened.
I want to listen to you. You're always saying crazy shit.
I am the truth teller. I only tell the truth.
Only the truth?
Yeah.
Like about the one time.
The one time I landed on the moon. I did.
What'd you see there?
It was 1943.
Name the five things you saw there. Five things.
I saw McDonald's. There was... three chihuahuas running in a pack.
Just dogs, okay.
And there was a golf course.
We cut to the very first moon landing.
Houston?
Yeah, can I take your order? I'm sorry, did you want fries with that?
McDonald's or Taco Bell? Can't tell.
I'm sorry, ignore the chihuahuas out front. Sir, this is indeed a McDonald's.
Yo quiero Taco Bell!
Competition is tough here on the moon, but we are the only valid fast food location sanctioned by the United States of God Bless America.
Great, Ken. Get like a Big Mac?
Sure.
Are you doing breakfast right now?
Always, all here on the moon.
24-hour breakfast?
Yes.
That's cool.
Yeah. Okay, all right. Is there anything else I can get for you, sir?
Steak, egg, and cheese, bacon?
No, actually, we don't have that here.
You know, I'm going to go somewhere else.
Have a great day, sir.
Told you.
It was on Discovery Channel.
Yeah, I told you. So, I am the truth teller. Always.
I believe you. Maybe I do believe you. One Discovery show and I believe you.
Hey, you got something on your shirt. Ah! Finally didn't tell the truth.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the first race of Cheetah versus Jaguar. In lane one, we've got Cheetah coming in at 27 pounds, 16 ounces. His mother was purebred of Cheetah on Cheetah action. In lane two, we've got a Jaguar. He is stylish, owned by Shad Khan himself. We picked him up from his backyard in a Ford F-150 and rode him all the way here. I did not know that they knew how to do push-ups. I'm gonna let this ride out for just a second before we start the race. We're gonna let them do. This is neither sanctioned nor discouraged by our organization. Keepers, stay back, please. Keepers, allow this to happen, please. Allow. No, keep the cameras rolling. Keep the cameras rolling. We'll start this when we start it. Okay, it looks like the animals are on their blocks. Now, they are unaware of the obstacles on the course. They are also unaware of how long the course... Oh, that was nasty, Jaguar. That was nasty. That's the wrong way. I guess go... Pachoo!
And that's how the cheetah became the fastest animal in the world.
Well, somebody ate the food, and I'm gonna find out who.
Wasn't me!
I had a pork chop sitting on this coffee table when I left. Maybe it disappeared. It did disappear.
Oh, it fell something.
Or one of you guys, David Blaine, David Copperfield?
No, trying to be.
He's been practicing with me. All of his jokes and tricks are shit. They're all shit.
Man, shut your mouth. I would like to see a crappy trick.
Make him do one.
I'm going to be a cool magician now.
You're trying to be a cool magician?
I'm going to be like Chris Angel or something.
Oh, the mind freak.
Yeah. Oh. Maybe your pork chop didn't disappear. Maybe you disappear and the pork chop's still there.
What?
I believe it.
What? I'm the pork chop?
Mind freak! No, you're still cat.
Whoa!
I'm trying to be David Copperfield. So tune your VCR to record my show at 8 p.m. So maybe all I had to do was use sleight of hand and the pork chop was gone. But you can't tell from the other side of your television set what really happened. Rewind it and see if you can figure it out. You won't be able to.
You're good. You guys are good. I just want my pork chop back, though.
Yeah, well, I can eat fish. Back up. Maybe I ate the pork chop and it's sitting in my esophagus right now.
What? I'm the pork chop and I'm in your gut? What?
It's exactly what I'm saying.
Guys. What's going on?
There is no pork chop. There never was.
The flowers, the birds, the bench.
Chirpity chirp 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 chirp. Lurpity derp 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 derp.
No, little lurp birds. Being here at this park reminds me of the first time we met. You know that?
Oh, this is the park
this
that we
is
met.
This is the bench, yeah.
Oh my gosh.
The very first one. You saw me sitting here reading Ayn Rand.
Mm-hmm.
And you were like, I want more of that in my life.
Of course.
Soulmates.
You know.
What?
I think I'd like to try some different kind of kisses.
Ooh, spice things up in the kissing world.
Mm-hmm.
What you mind?
Heat things up with an Eskimo kiss.
Ooh, Eskimo kisses, I like that.
Oh, no.
That was a butterfly.
Okay.
That was a butterfly kiss. I followed your lead, though.
Thank you so much. You're so good at that. I don't know how to teach you that.
Yeah, she said always follow the train. How about Eskimo kisses now?
Okay.
tickled.
I love you, man.
I love you.
I love you.
You know what else I love?
What?
Fishing. How about some fishy kisses?
I'll catch whatever you have any day. You know that?
No.
You know,
you
I've been.
Enjoy herpes.
I'm so enamored, I'm gonna ignore that sentence. You know, I've been seeing all those Marvel movies on Netflix.
Yes.
I wanna try something a little different.
Okay.
It's about like a Spider-Man kiss.
Oh! I'll be your Kirsten Dunst. I'm Toby.
Oh, yeah. That is disgusting. That is disgusting. Give life!
Yeah, something. I mean, or rent the DVD of Spider-Man.
Yeah. You can see a higher quality production for a cheaper rate at the Red Box.
Yeah. People pay for this.
You know what will get me in a better mood?
What?
Frog kisses.
How did you rearrange this bitch so easily?
I'm broken!
Very odd. Frog kisses?
Frog kisses.
Oh no. I hit my titty on the chair.
I wanted to try your lunch again. Oh, you know what?
What?
Let's do some motorboat kisses.
This bitch is so ugly.
You perv!
Look where you're going, yeah. Sir! You're gonna get it! What a roller blader!
You wanna see more?
What was that?
I don't know.
People in this park are very strange.
Good odd birds. Odd birds.
So is this bitch.
Magical little bitch. You know what? One thing I've always wanted to try, just a little too nervous to ask you about it. Butt stuff. I want some butt kisses.
Does my standing say anything? Oh, we're gonna. Okay.
Oh, oh, oh my God, Fido, close your eyes! My dog is offended. My dog is offended.
Well,
I.
Oh, I know why the dog is offended. Hold on. That, you have to do that first.
I swear, I have never been so in love with you before. Will you, my kissiest kisser, promise to be my kissing kiss forever?
I do, I do, I do! I don't think that's the right thing.
It's fine. 35 years in a marriage kiss.
Man.
You up for it tonight?
No, it's just like watch Netflix or something.
They got the Jeopardy championships on now.
Yeah, that sounds invigorating.
I'm not Viagra anyway, so it really wouldn't, you know.
I'm gonna go get some water.
What is the boom of this?
Over to the right, we have the zebras. We call them Sabres, if you will. Yeah. Both black and white. And if you notice, their stripes will go up into their mane. It is remarkable. Hence, I'm remarking on it. Yeah.
A safari joke.
Oh! Ah! Ah! That was an impressive falling, little buddy! Okay. Alright, he's possessed. Yeah. I think we go for a clothesline here. No, just double team. Oh, that was a real clothesline! Okay, he's dead. Okay, oh. He is down. It looks like he got a new tattoo while he was out. It's on his chest. Oh, your nipples are hard from that. It says, intermission. Come on. Okay, well, I'm glad I got to read that. I'm going to let somebody who's, you know, paid more deal with this situation. We're going to take a break. That sound good to you?
See you guys in 10.
No.
What? Hey, guys, welcome back to the show. How's everybody doing?
Fantastic.
Break. Cool. Yeah. Before we get the show back on the party bus, we got a few more raffles to give away. You guys want to do that?
Yeah.
Did anybody else buy raffle tickets? Yeah. Woo. Good for you guys. Nice.
Can we let Blake do that?
Well, we actually care a little bit of a bit. Yeah. So, if you, Karen, if you introduce what the first prize is, and then we'll take a minute.
Well, you guys might have to look it up to figure out how to get here, but this is two tickets to another show at the Blue Jay Listening Room and a t-shirt.
Ooh!
But sadly, no Blake.
Okay, no Blake. You know what? It would be really easy if we just walked over there, got a name out, and read it.
We're not gonna do that.
No, Randy, I got a challenge for you. I would like to see you get to that donation jar as if you're Winona Ryder who's just seen for the first time the final script of Stranger Things. Blue Jay. Guys, get it for Randy. That was committed.
No. I'm paying him back.
What?
All right, let's do a little scene painting, boys. You ready?
Oh, God.
You ready? All right. First up, right here in this part of the stage,
yeah.
Bash.
Uh-huh.
We're going to see the crag from Nickelodeon's guts, and you've got to get over it.
I don't know what that is, but got it.
It's a mountain.
Mountain.
Wait, what's up? What's over? What's up? What's by the mountain?
Oh, the scary guy.
There's a scary guy right here.
Good. Got it.
Okay. And Kevin, what's after
the
scary guy?
After the scary guy is a group of Jehovah Witnesses.
Ooh, gotta get through them. Gotta get through them. On your mark. Get set. Go!
See you.
Hi.
Hi. Are you chosen? Are you a chosen one?
$50 gift certificate for Homespun Kitchen, Atlantic Beach, Aaron's Woo! Place.
Woo! Great, Charlene Stockton! Yay!
Yay! All right, I got one for you, Kevin, and you, Sebastian.
Oh, so two in a row, goody. All right.
I want to see you two improvise a song together.
Oh. And then draw?
And then draw.
How long is the song after?
Wait, no, but you gotta improvise a song until there's laughter. When there's laughter, you cannot draw a name until there's laughter, okay? And the audience has to try as hard as they can not to laugh.
Way to lead them, Blake.
Yeah. Can we get a suggestion for them to sing about?
Hangers.
Hangers?
Great.
I'm a little hanger. I house airplanes. All of the planes go inside me. Then I let them out.
You want to know what you're winning, right? It's another show with them. No, really. It's a party on a Saturday at Bach to Rock. It's an adult party or a children's party. You can bring your own drinks and food and everything. And it's a lot of fun.
Great. Charlene Stockton again. You know what? You know what, Blake? That wasn't fair. This time, you and Rand have to do a synchronized dance to whatever beat I make up right now.
That's easy enough.
Yeah, but it has to be, like, synchronized.
Okay.
It has to be, like, five different dance moves at least.
All right, can I stretch for just a second?
Look, we're stretching together. We're
There's
stretching
no
together.
Music yet.
We're already starting.
This is how I stretch every day.
Showing on stage right now, like a toy or a
SpongeBob.
What does SpongeBob need to talk about?
Sex education.
Sex education. All right. We'll do this monologue style until one of us gets a laugh talking about doing SpongeBob and sex education.
I don't know SpongeBob's voice.
Oh, I got this.
Okay.
Just because you see a hole in a sponge doesn't mean you can do something with it.
Anna again.
Anna, what did Anna win?
Anna, you won a round of golf at PGA.
Oh! All right,
if you don't golf, it's a great Christmas present.
This final one, that jar is so small. I think we all try and bare-hand it at once.
Okay.
That's all we do, yeah.
All right, so we start here. What are we drawing for in this final one?
This is really amazing. It's a Kraken Cycle pedal boat on the St. John's River.
Do we get to drive
it? It's a booze cruise. It's a booze cruise.
Place your fingers.
What?
Okay.
$160 value.
Oh my god, this is just like last night. This is like last night.
I think it's still.
Hold on, wait, hold on. Make it work.
Oh no.
Okay, he's got one.
Got it.
Release?
It's Anna.
Ashley Smith!
Yeah!
One more round of applause for Karen catching through kids, everybody!
Thank you guys so much for supporting such a wonderful organization.
Yes, indeed. And now it's time
to- Hey, wait a minute. I know you. You're Pitbull! You can have anything you want to drink. And Pitbull's like, I want the hotel, motel, Holiday Inn.
That's Pitbull. $185 hotels walk into a bar. Bartender says, we don't serve hotels here. Boardwalk yourself right on out. They had a monopoly.
$185 lonely arborist walk into a hotel bar.
Okay.
We're getting there. And the bartender's like, we don't serve lonely arborists in this hotel. And they're like, oh, come on, we thought it was a double tree. Oh! All right, can I get another letter from the audience? Letter of the alphabet.
D.
R. What is an object that's not... Never mind. What's an object that starts with R?
Rattle.
Rattle. Rattle.
Rattle.
Rattle.
Rattle.
185 rattles walk into a bar. Bartender says, we don't serve rattles here. And the rattles go, wah! Wah!
185 rattles walk into the bar. And the bartender says, whoa, whoa, whoa! We are not serving you here.
It's a rattlesnake. Not a baby. They're poisonous.
This is
it's
why
dangerous.
This is why we're okay with him leaving. The proper way to do that joke would have been 185 rattles walk into a bar. Bartender says, we don't serve you guys here. And the rattles go, yes.
All right, different take on it.
Okay.
185 rattles walk into the bar. Bartender's like, not you guys again. You guys are always trying to cut out on your tab, and the rattles are like, oh, come on, it's just what we do. And the bartender's like, nah, you're a bunch of snakes.
Yay! That's how you do it. You don't have to tell them what the joke is.
It's my first time.
Can we get one more suggestion for 185? So we got a letter from the side of the room.
K.
And an object that starts with the letter K.
Kite.
Kite.
185
kites. 185 kites.
185 kites, you know, do that into a bar. And the bartender's like, we don't serve kites here. And it's like, oh, come on, man, we're just trying to get a high.
Oh, that's 185 kites walking to a bar. Bartender says, we don't serve kites here. And they're like, hey, we're just trying to get some tail.
Hey!
185 kites walk into a bar, and the bartender says, hey, look, you're cut off, you can't drink here anymore. And the kites are like, hey, what's the problem? And the bartender's like, well, you just keep, like, blowing and blowing, and we don't like that.
Are you sure you don't like that, Kevin?
Not what we heard.
185 kites walk into the bar, and the bartender's like, we don't serve strings either. There's string on kite as well.
Yay!
Yeah, so we already said at the start of the show, he's the Rudy of the team. So like, give him encouragement.
Rudy.
Our next game is called Innuendo, where we tell you how we like our men or like our women, very plain and simply. This is only dirty if you have a dirty mind, so don't blame us for this one. Can I get a suggestion of a non-sexy object?
Peanuts.
Peanuts. Peanuts.
I like my women like I like my peanuts. Afterward, I get all swollen faced.
All
and I may need to go to the hospital.
I like my women, like I like my peanuts on like Phillips or something, or like Blanding, wherever, at like 2 a.m. I'll cash you outside.
I like my men like I like my peanuts. After I'm done enjoying them going down the road, their juice is all over my chest.
I like my women like I like my peanuts. It's over in a jiffy.
I like my women like I like my peanuts at the baseball game. They come in twos.
Kevin likes his men like he likes his peanuts forever young, like Peter Pan.
We'll go on to a new one. Can I get a suggestion of another non-sexy object?
Kitty. Chair.
Did you say kitty?
Yeah. Oh, come on. Oh, come on.
Kitty.
Too easy.
You're too easy. Let's get another non-sexy object. Her name is Kitty, by the way.
Ketchup bottle.
What?
Ketchup bottle.
Ketchup bottle. Ketchup bottle.
Oh, God. Oh, God. I like my women like I like my ketchup bottle. It's usually stuck and then it all comes out at once.
I like my men like I like my ketchup bottles. I gotta flip them upside down and spank them before anything comes out.
I like my women like I like my ketchup bottles. At the family picnic, everyone gets a squeeze.
Your family is so fucked up. I like my men like I like my ketchup bottles. You got a hunts for it.
Oh!
Oh. Hunt.
Good
it's
one!
A hunt on hunts.
Get another non-sexy object.
Yo-yo?
Yo-yo.
Yo-yo.
That makes a lot more sense. Yo-yo.
I like my women like I like my yo-yos. No matter how far I throw them, they just keep coming back, back, back.
I like my women like I like my yo-yos. Up and down and down and up and down and up. I never get tired.
I'm very sorry. I like my women like I like my yo-yos. Tricked out.
That's totally okay. I thought you were going to talk about children.
I like my men. My one man. One single man in my life. Like my yo-yos. Duncan. My yo-yo fans out there. It's a yo-yo brand.
It's always a good joke.
Can he not do the second half of the show?
We have one more game for you. We're gonna move on from this. And Blake's not gonna be allowed to ever do it again. It's called Pick Up Lines. Anybody single in the audience tonight? Any single folk out there? A couple people here and there. Yeah! Woo!
Yeah! Yeah. Yeah.
Two.
Two
of them.
Wait, are they in the same party?
Guys, we just solved this.
Not and done.
Yeah, can I get a session of a non-sexy object again?
It's a funny story.
Oh, we're gonna give you pickup lines, by the way. We're gonna give you pickup lines to use.
Yeah, what have you been doing?
Yeah. You're single.
No, a letter, please, or not to the object, anything at all.
Shoe!
What?
Helmet.
I'll strap it on.
You might need this so you don't get any brain damage.
I'd like to see you on my head.
You look like you're ready
take some balls to the face.
Hey, little mama, you look like you're ready for the big leagues.
Get another object. One more.
How about this?
One more.
It's a good idea to protect that head.
Get one more.
Yeah.
One more.
Cactus.
Cactus. Great.
Cactus. I like a good prick.
Up a little bit, and by that I mean we're gonna do some more long form and slow it all the way down. So, I need one volunteer who's feeling brave right now, who's had a few too many drinks and wants to get on stage for a little bit. No. Come hang out. Yeah. Oh, wait, he's already stood up. Yeah. What is your name?
My name is Buddy.
Buddy, everybody! How did you? Yeah, it's part of your buddy. That's why we can do this. Yeah, perfect. How did you hear about the show?
My friend Matt Merritt in the back.
Hey, Matt. Appreciate it, bud.
Do some marketing, Matt.
Yeah, how do you know Matt?
Well, Matt moved here from Atlanta about 20 years ago.
Okay.
We were his first friends when he came here. Amazingly, we stayed friends all the time.
Matt, can you corroborate this story? Is this true?
Yeah, it's true.
Wait, what else? Is Matt a woman?
Even more shockingly, Matt is married. Yeah, that's his wife.
Oh, wow.
Married. Are you married?
Yeah, I am. My wife's back there, too.
How did you and your wife meet? Was it 20 years ago when she came from Atlanta?
That's so funny you bring that up.
What?
I met my wife outside a bar in Buckhead, Atlanta.
Okay.
Just over 20 years ago.
Yeah, 25, actually, gonna be 25.
25, great. How did that go down? You walked out of the bar and were like, I'm looking for a lady. She's like,
I tried to get in, they wouldn't let me in.
Okay, that's enough.
Shouldn't let me come up here.
Buddy, I won't force you to do it, but if you're up for it, can we hear a little tidbit?
Well, it was the Final Four weekend, 1993.
Okay.
There was eight basketball fans in the audience. It was the year that Chris Webber called the timeout.
Oh,
wow. Caroline won the national championship that year. So, me and some guys came down from Chattanooga. I lived in Tulsa. We had nothing to do, and we ended up bar hopping in Buckhead outside the Rock Moon Lodge, and tried to get in around 2 o'clock in the morning. They were shutting down and wouldn't let me in. And her friend was making out with some guy in the alley. She wanted to go home really bad. She didn't want to go out that night. And I looked over. I swear to God, the first thing I said to her was, "What's your story?" We started talking. We had a couple things in common. She was from Chattanooga. I had lived in Chattanooga previously. And my friends, I had one friend in all of Atlanta at that point in time. And that kid, all his fraternity guy mates from FSU were getting in their cabs and going back to the place where I was supposed to be spending the night. And I said, I had a thought. I saw those guys getting in the cab. This little girl was sitting here next to me, and I was talking to her.
More!
I had to choose. Do I run over there to those guys and say, hey, hang on, let me in the cab? Or do I keep talking to this girl? And I was like, I'm letting those dudes go.
We're now going to improvise based on that story you just heard. Welcome, everybody.
First time in an alley, big boy? Yes.
You see that big burly fellow down there?
Yeah, I see him.
I'm gonna go make out with him.
No, why him? I'm right here for you.
Dangerous.
Got a switchblade in my butt. And a cigarette in my left hand.
Well, that's really dangerous.
You really want to go for big burly burly down there? What do you want? Switchblade McGee.
You know what's really catching my attention?
Got it, man.
That mutt down there going through Burly's leg.
Well, you go take a trip, see what Burly and his dog are like. I'll be over here cutting my scars.
They think I'm a rat. Shh.
Yes?
Mr. Burly?
What's your story?
I'm single. 22.
That's a good start.
22.
22.
Dog yep. Lover.
Hey, that's enough. I'm done with this scene. It's enough of this scene. I want to hear no more of this scene. Just stop. Yeah, we can't hear the rest of this. It's too much.
We're gonna start over.
No, I'm just uncomfortable as like a wife scenario. I just don't want to see the rest of the scene.
I think I'm gonna keep going, honey. Basically, fuck her. I don't care.
I wasn't a dog the whole time. What? You were what were you?
An alley man.
An alley man.
People think are dogs.
That was your best alley man?
That's Alley Man Jones.
We never know what you're going to say.
Get your dirty hands off of my woman's tits.
You claiming that?
I heard her story. She said she was single and a dog person.
Can't argue with the story.
It was a good one.
Yeah.
Well, what do you say we moved to Jacksonville getting married?
I say we do it.
We come to Jacksonville in like their fourth year here.
It is hot as shit, man.
Landing's bullcrap. Tear it down.
Hi, I'm Matt. I don't have any friends.
We don't have any friends. What's your story?
Well, I'm single right now. But from this place called the Raccoon Lodge in North Carolina. The Raccoon Lodge, yeah.
I know that.
Some people say raccoon.
Raccoon. I've always wondered how it's pronounced.
Yeah.
Honey, I have this.
Okay.
So there's this take one time I was going to figure out how to pronounce raccoon. But then I realized I didn't know how to pronounce raccoon. So I got a dictionary to look up the pronunciation of raccoon. But you're not going to get this. My best friend has a raccoon. Right? And the raccoon...
Who are you talking to?
I just talk too much.
We're in the landing. There's so many times. What is this?
Alley boy.
Oh, I got you fooled!
I got you fooled!
My boy! Alley boy!
I followed you all the way here.
Time out! Time out!
You don't have
a time in!
Never mind.
Time out?
Time in?
Out!
Time in!
I won. So you have to eat my goldfish alive.
This is how we become best friends?
This is how we become mortal enemies, because you're eating my goldfish!
It's there.
Is it?
I think so. Maybe. Possibly.
He's right behind you.
Right behind you.
I have 107,000 gallon tank right behind you, and Garfield, my goldfish, is swimming behind you.
What do you want me to do again?
Eat him.
Eat the whole thing? Is that him? Oh,
hey bud.
That goldfish is at least 200 pounds.
Special about my goldfish?
I'd love to. Hit me with it.
He's the only goldfish in North America with a beard!
Cool.
It's not going to taste good on your tongue. He sweats a lot. He won't like that either.
Does he have a... One thing, okay, I gotta know more. Does he own a suitcase? Like, if you go to a hotel, does he have a suitcase?
I've never traveled with him. But I would imagine he packs well.
I heard he doesn't have a suitcase. I heard he only has a box that he puts his clothes in and takes it to the hotel. When you're on an improv festival trip.
One thing I do know, with my goldfish, occasionally I like to play dress up. His piss poor choice. He likes to wear shrimp shirts on special occasions, like show night.
You want me to eat this guy? This fish?
Yes.
Well,
you didn't eat him! You didn't eat him! You spit him out!
It smelled too bad. I felt it inside. It smelled way too sweaty. Way too sweaty. Came right out.
I told you.
Blake, Kevin, can I just talk to you guys? Ranch and Kevin, if you want to.
I'm gonna stand here. I'm scared.
The last scene we just did.
Yeah? Tell
them. A lot of personal attacks.
Actually, I'm on their side.
No, we wanted to see.
They actually missed a few things. They missed the fact that you still live with your parents. They missed the fact that oftentimes when we're out, I have to pay for you. I'm pretty sure when I sift your butt earlier, you haven't wiped for days. So, plenty of material left. You missed a sketch. You were backstage.
I just feel, I'm using I statements.
Okay.
I think if I were to say something like, Rans,
yeah,
you smell like a dried fish half the time.
Not true.
You would be really offended.
And if I were to say something like, fish has been Febreze.
Kevin, I think you have no dick or balls. You can't stand up for yourself ever.
That's true.
Offensive to you.
Hold on. Time out.
You have no timeouts left to learn that.
Like, hey, Blake, I think you are really ugly, even though, like, people like to sleep with you, apparently.
Well, we know he's a poor, but he is very good looking. Look at him. I would fuck him.
His hair's a mess.
You're gonna talk about his hair?
He's pretty hot.
Yeah. Wait, is that my dad?
It is.
Alright, I just wanted to get that off my chest.
You wanted to get that off your chest? Yeah. Man, you get some hair off of your chest. It's disgusting.
I'll do it next.
Yeah. Alright.
it looks to be in order, but you can never be too certain. Because bananas have a way of jumping out of bunches. You have to watch it carefully. They turn together. See this?
They all seem pretty green, pretty new, pretty fresh.
See, that's the problem with bananas. They're only green for a day or two, and then they get all experienced. They start ripening with wisdom.
You gotta catch them while they're young.
Yes.
Teach them the ways.
Yes. Teach them the way of the plantains. Convert them.
Deep fry. The whole date, you wanted to talk about bananas.
It was fucking weird.
And train them. And how they wanted to change to plantains. And you go to the zoo.
Look, I played along. I was like, yeah. And like. Yeah.
Did I tell you about the time I was in the Bahamas and rode a banana boat?
Tell me more. I'm wildly interested.
Never been on a banana boat before. It's kind of exciting.
I'm half banana.
I'm Susan.
I'm Chiquita.
It's nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you. You been growing here long?
Yeah, I decided to be a Bahama Susan. You heard of me? I'm an indigenous banana.
You're a banana? You don't look like a banana. You look like a shriveled up leftover produce item at my local grocery store.
Well, Bahama Susan's quite offended by that, but also kind of into it. Never had someone insult me before.
You like
that? I like it when you talk dirty to me. Anyways, Mr. Chiquita.
You know what I like?
Okay, I won't finish my sentence. That's fine.
I like you're the only one paddling.
It's pretty easy boat to paddle. I haven't held on to a single point.
He made you paddle the whole time?
It was
tired. That's caramel macchiato. Nice choice.
Thank you, sir.
You're new around here. I've never seen you here before.
Well, I am. I just moved here from Atlanta. So, like, what do people do for fun around here?
Well, I mean, we're at the beach. People like to go over to the beach and, like, you know, maybe go out to Riverside every once in a while. Maybe check out a jazz game.
Been to the beach. I've heard of the Jags, but what's Riverside?
Wait, what's Riverside? Mm-hmm. You've never been outside of the beach? You've never been to Riverside before?
Not ringing any bells.
Oh my gosh, we're gonna have to change that.
Okay.
I can show you Duval.
South side, Riverside, downtown. Tell me, princess, now when did you last have to cross that damn ditch?
Never.
I can drive you around, take you section by section, over bridges and under on a crazy Bolt City ride. A Riverside world, a new hipster point of view. No one without beards or bikes to ride or thick frame glasses to wear. A Southside world, a dizzying place I never knew. But when I'm in town center, it's crystal clear. I wanna shoot myself in the face. Indescribable sights, indescribable feelings, landing, blending in Northside, where you do not want to be. A bold new world, a couple hundred things to see. But I'm a terrible guy, I stay inside.
We just Netflix and chill.
Downtown world too, with homeless to harass you. The Jacks play over there. They're actually playing right now, tonight. But they'll still find a way to disappoint you. A bold new world.
That's where we live. A thrilling chase. A spread.
Me. And that's the show!
Ladies and gentlemen, we're here! We made it! But Scott, turn it off! Normally, this would be the very end of the show. However, things will be a little different tonight. As it was mentioned, there's some bad news. Blake, we go ahead and have a seat right here, but we wrote a little thing for you. I hope you don't mind. Scott, whenever you're ready, man. Yeah, because we wrote this today, so I don't know the words, but here we go.
So we've got some bad news. Blakey Wakey is leaving, packing his bags and moving all the way to Atlanta. Blake just ruined our world, leaving, deserting his friends. Tell me, princess, now why did you decide to pull out now? It's not. I know it's shocking to us too, but he has a son he cares about. We're kind of glad he's leaving. Fuck you, Blake. You weren't that funny anyway. You cannot act or improvise, but your sex appeal is what saved you.
Fuck you, Blake.
That's what we said.
That's what we said.
You're a disgrace with a precious face,
and we'll miss you.
And get more information as you go out. Just slip her a 20 if you want. Come on now.
Yeah, I do. Thank you to Karen. We just listening to us have this show here for 21 shows now. Her 2 year anniversary this Sunday, so come and see that.
2 years! And we're here to Jacksonville Beach!
Underdog!
Underdog's 2-year anniversary is in November, so come back and say hey to us then. We're still going to be kicking, hopefully.
Without this guy.
Yeah, without this.
We'll be way less sexy.
Yeah.
I'm going to lose some weight, though. I'm going to look
great. All right. Rams will look sexier. Blake's gone. Kevin and I are going to drink more. Yeah. Thank you to Jackie on camera. Thank you to Scott in the tech booth. Most importantly, thank you to you guys.